and sisters, put your hands together for Apocalypse.
Peace. Here we go. Another day from the Dust of Apocalypse. Dogs Gods Entertainment. Yeah. Just lay back. Look. I'm excited, you know what I'm saying? Because we're on a mission, man, and you see it in the background. Walking the road to recovery. 9 steps in motion. You know, what has me so excited is that we always understood, not always, but since we've been in this process of self-improvement, the basis of community development, under the teachings of the Most High Elijah Muhammad, under the perfect guidance of our Mr. Louis Farrakhan, just analyzing and watching how things go. Like, back in the 90s, you know, before we had social media, you know, when it was time for the ominous Louis Farrakhan to come to town, man, let me tell you something. The organization of the FOI and the MGT, the bad guy, you know what I'm saying? We, man, we went to work, you know what I'm saying? Man, by the time you woke up the next day, you see posters plastered all over the city, you know what I'm saying? The brothers, man, let me tell you, back in the 90s, you had to get up early in the morning to get a spot. Because if you slept, if you came out too late, man, every block is plastered with soldiers, man. It's like, where am I going? What you going to do? So we had to create spots, you know what I'm saying? But that's how we moved out, though. Like, whenever it's time to let the people know, which is always, on a daily, consistent basis, you gotta be out there with the program. If you want to accomplish the goal. And that's what we talk about, accomplishing the goal. Now this book right here, Walk the Road to Recovery, 9 Steps in Motion, it took me over 10 years to actually sit down and write it. I started years ago and you know what I mean? I didn't finish. It just wasn't time for me. I wasn't ready. You know what I'm saying? But recently, we were blessed to sit down and finish it, right? And, man, I got a powerful brother, man. A powerful soldier, man, that's doing the voiceover for the audiobook, right? And so, man, he sent me what he's done so far. We almost did. We about a third of the way finished, right? And, man, I'm telling you, man, let me tell you something. Recognizing this my word for the day right here, because I read in a book, and I promote the book because it's a powerful book, John C. Maxwell, you know, the 17 Irrefutable Laws of Teamwork. Man, it's a powerful book, and one of the laws is, you know, the law of the niche or niche, you know what I'm saying? And so if I'm analyzing what I'm working with, you know, if I'm managing a group of people, or if I see, or if I'm a part of a group and I want to get something done with that group, you know what I'm saying? The law of the niche, whatever, however you say it, I'm, you know, I'm black, man, so you know what I'm saying, right? It's powerful because that means you gotta know something about a person to help them find their niche. what I'm saying? They may know what it is, but you know, you don't know. But then if they know and you know, then you can get the best use out of that person, if that's your intent. Because the objective is to reach the goal. And if you have a group of people, or just one other person, that's going to help you along the way, then find out what they do best. And then find out how to utilize that to help you get to where you're striving to go. You know what I'm saying? The law of the niche. You know what I'm saying? That's a powerful law, because then that person is working in their purpose. And they're not doing something, you know, that they really don't care to do. But if they're doing something that they care to do, if they're doing something that they put time and energy in, or a thing that they do effortlessly because they were born to do it, man, you're going to get the best out of that person, and then you're going to get to where you're going a little faster. You know what I'm saying? We were talking about strategy and tactics last night. Strategy, see, you got to know the big picture. And then once you know the big picture, you have to know how to skillfully paint the big picture in the minds of those that's going to help you, so that when you get tactical in your moves and your plan of action, your day-to-day operation, you know what I'm saying? It's already in their minds. It's already in your mind. And you know their niche. And they could just place it. I need you to go ahead and do that. You ain't even got to oversee them. Stay in their niche. Man, do that. Yo, go do that. You understand what I'm saying? Do that. That's you. That's yours. You the god of that. You know what I mean? And, hey, I'm just going to claim the victory with you. You dig? Yeah. So that's our word today from the Depth of the Pockets. We have some exciting things coming with Walking the Road Recovery 9-Step Promotion. So just stay tuned. Alright? That's our word today from the Depth of the Pockets. If you're in Chi-Town, we at the Foodie Spot, 7350 South Stony Island Avenue. Come on through and show us some love today. Alright? Peace!